speaking of how strong I am, I am really good at breaking things. But you are not a rear-ended car, and I am not a set of snapped guitar strings. Loving you came much more easily than fucking up my car, but fucking up my car came after fucking you. When our rational friends raised their eyebrows at us and shook their heads, it was then that I realized they saw us as puzzle pieces with the same dysfunctions. But we are far less inanimate than that. We were blooming in our bliss, loving without apologies. You insisted that I shouldn't say sorry for being a fool. Waddling through the grocery store like a penguin became more than socially acceptable. I climbed through your window when you were sick because it seemed more practical at the time. We left trails of adrenaline mapping the coffee shops of Minneapolis and spent daybreak curled into my couch with Jones Soda whittling away our teeth. You told me that I was the calm within your storm. That when you were with me, the hurricanes, the tornadoes, all that weather in your head went silent. Being me was not only enough, but it is so much. It was so much for you to love. Until someone else's hands and kisses tried to tear me open. A stranger who didn't care that my mouth moved against his lips to the words no and stop. That in the morning I would wake up in someone else's body. That when I crawled into bed again, I could not pull the covers close enough to stop my skin from shivering. That my arms would be too frail to hold myself together. But you were so angry at me for being attacked. Angry at a broken door for being kicked in without looking twice at the person who kicked it. But I am not a door. I do not open and close. You could not understand how I had let this happen. All that fear in me scared you. You were frightened by how suddenly I shattered, always citing your pain, your tampered heart. You finally wanted me to say sorry, but I do not have time to fall apart simply because I am expected to. I do not have time to be that weak. I've been waiting for a late night when I get off of work and meet an unwelcome stranger on the way home. I will thrust a pocket knife into his gut or claw his eyes out to prove that I am not harmless, that I am really good at breaking things, that if you threaten my life, I am willing to step closer to the edge and dare you to push because I am not a door. I am not a broken heart or an apology. I am not the calm in your storm. I do not have time to fall apart simply because I am expected to. I have always been so much more.